What's up guys, this video is going to be about my arm programming. How do I program arms? What kind of exercises do I do for the arms? Just talking about arm programming in general and things like that. I'm probably going to do some kind of other arm videos in the future, maybe talking more specifically about like exercises, exercise selection obviously, and for the biceps, triceps and forearms, maybe going more in depth in specific topics. But this is going to be just talking about my arm programming right now, how it's changed over time, what are my priorities, and how do I do things for my arms. And I just wanted to go over this since it's kind of a relevant topic for me, since I've been focusing a lot more on my arm training as of late than really anything, and just generally switching to bodybuilding style training. But anyways, let's get into the video itself. So first of all, to go over my past with arm training. So I kind of started out, first of all, just doing some arms, like eight sets a week. I did that for a long time, like pretty much over a year of my training, like just eight sets a week, which is not really ideal. But I was kind of doing more strength type training, so I was focusing a lot on the compounds. And maybe you can kind of see that in my physique as well, a little bit. My arms are not my strong suit though. Let's just say genetically arms are not my strong suit, and I probably haven't spent enough time in a bulk and so on. And my mistakes probably would be maybe a lack of volume and lack of exercise selection for the arms. Lack of volume and exercise selection is a big thing. Not enough bulking time spent with good arm programming. So those were some of my past mistakes that I've made with arm training for sure, is just not focusing on the volume and just bulking. I would say if I did actually bulk, I would have made a lot of progress and actually did proper volume. Right now I'm doing like double the volume pretty much right now, so between like 14 to 16 sets a week of arms, and that's a lot already for like biceps, for example, just for one bicep training week. And same thing, somewhat similar for triceps and forearms as well. And I have noticed definitely some improvements in that regard. For sure, it's like, it definitely makes a huge difference. It's like, I kind of was at that novice stage where I was focused on the compounds and everything else. And I thought, you know, this is fine. I'm doing it twice a week, four sets, you know, twice a week. And I was like, that's fine. But honestly, I felt like I really need to focus on the arms and go for it. And that's the only way to really get progress for the arms. Anyways, let's get into the arm programming tidbits, and we'll go on from there. So how did I change my arm programming? Okay, as I said, I used to do eight sets a week, and I feel like I had a lack of volume, and that might be the biggest reason why I didn't see any progress, just the lack of volume and exercise selection. I've introduced a lot cleaner form in my arm programming, so I focused on the technique. I've increased the volume, I'm bulking, obviously lean bulking, and just changing the way I have things set up for the arms. So I prioritize the arms a lot more, and I also have an arm day now, which makes a huge difference for volume. I can pretty much double the volume because of the arm day. I mean, I went training on that day specifically anyway, so I was like, might as well have an arm day here. So that's what I decided to do. And as far as my programming goes right now, I'll pull up on the screen, for example, what I have for an arm day, and then I'll maybe pull up some of the different ways that I program my arms, for example, on just like a upper lower, which is what I'm running right now. I'm gonna show you on screen what type of different ways you can program it. I personally program it either at the start, like maybe if I want to do biceps at the start as a focus, or I usually put it in with the rest of the arm somewhere in between, kind of after the compounds. This is kind of personal preference, and if you just want to focus on your arms, you should definitely prioritize them over like compound lifts for sure. Maybe even remove some compound lifts if you really don't need them. At the end of the day, it's not necessary to do deadlifts, or you could just do Romanian deadlifts. Like, you can juggle a lot of these compounds and things like that around for bodybuilding sake. The reason I changed my arm programming and program in general is to accommodate more bodybuilding and to accommodate the arm training and to really get that ideal arm size, because I feel like my arms have been the biggest part that's lacking in my physique for a long time. My legs are pretty big, my back is pretty good, delts and chest is okay, and I felt like my arms are really what I need to bring up next, so that's what I'm focusing on. Obviously I'm focusing on other things as well, but anyways, that's beside the point. As far as my future with arms goes, I'm probably gonna run a similar thing that I'm running right now. I kind of like it, and I feel like if my arms do get really big at some point, I might focus on them less and focus on something else, and maybe that will change my programming, but we'll see. Either way, let's get into the movements next. So next I'm gonna put on screen an example list of movements that I like doing, and I guess I'll go over all the movements. So first of all, let's start out with biceps. Personally for me, it's pretty much incline curls, spider curls, hammer curls, or like a pinwheel curl. That's either or. Some easy bar curls, like close grip and normal easy bar curls, maybe some preacher curls. Honestly, I really only have like 6-7 variations pretty much that I do and run in my program. I don't do more than that. All you really need for the bicep is some kind of weighted stretch, some kind of peak contraction movement, and then something for maybe the long head itself, and some kind of heavy loading. That's what I would say is what you need for the biceps, and you pretty much have it covered, so that's all you really need for the biceps, excuse me. And as far as triceps go, for the triceps I apply the same logic. You have the different heads of the tricep that you need to work, and for that I train personally. I mostly train the long head because you get a lot of short head training from bench and close grip bench, which is what I do. So I get a lot of short head from there, though I still might do short head here and there just to kind of supplement it more. And the long head is really the one that's like actually visible once you flex. Like this short head is less visible, and the short head kind of gets developed anyway a lot more than the long head does by itself, because you don't have to isolate the long head pretty much. As far as forearms go, my forearm training is quite varied. I guess I can pull up a list of exercises that I would do for the forearms. The main ones that I do right now is like wrist curls, maybe wrist extensions, reverse curls. So maybe those three like are the main ones I do per week. But you can also do like dead man hang holds, and you can do all these different things and different holds for the forearms. And you can use fat grips and all these other things. But maybe I'll pull up some list of exercises here for forearms that I would do. I don't always go too crazy with it, but that's what I do. I also do some Captain Crushers like maybe once or twice a week. I'm kind of lazy with those, I'm not gonna lie. It's not my favorite thing to do, but I try to do them here and there. Now recovery with arms, let's touch on that subject. I think recovery with arms is very easy. The forearms recover super fast, so you don't need to worry about using the forearms at all, because the forearms recover straight away. Biceps and triceps, you need to be, with triceps you need to be a bit careful, because if you're benching and doing a lot of any kind of chest movement that usually uses the triceps, any kind of benching and things like that, dips, those are going to use your triceps to an extent, so you need to think about the recovery a little bit when it comes to that, if you're trying to recover for the bench press or so on. So I do find that you need to take into account that with recovery is how much you're benching and what is your priority and focus. Then as far as injury prevention, usually the elbow is where injuries start to come in, at least with the triceps, and maybe a little bit with the biceps, since you're holding this position all the time. You're always holding something, so that might cause some elbow tendonitis and things like that. So there's different methods to alleviate that, and I might make some videos maybe on those in the future, what I use personally for injury prevention and just helping ease pain. but those would be my main things. Just like you need to work some kind of a movement, for example with bands that help with just your elbows healing a bit better and not getting tendonitis. Is basically just doing movements with bands that help them, basically just doing some kind of movements to help aid recovery with arms. But otherwise, arms are, I don't really deload arms. I usually always do the same volume and intensity because I don't really feel the need to actually decrease volume or intensity too much on the arms. You can vary the intensity, but I don't see any point like decreasing volume, because it's like the arms recover really fast anyway, so I don't think they really need a deload personally. Now I'm just gonna go over some arm tidbits when it comes to programming arms. And first of all, volume and intensity. As far as volume goes, I really like doing, unless it's an arm day specifically, I might do closer to 10 sets if it's an arm day. But on normal upper lower day, I usually do 4 sets of like select like biceps, and the rep range is somewhere between usually 8 to 15 pretty much most of the time. That's what I like. But you can vary between like probably 5 to 20 or 6 to 20 for more ideal hypertrophy effects. It doesn't really matter too much. Intensity, you're gonna have to kind of figure out for yourself what you want. Do you want to go heavy specifically or lower, lighter weight? Doesn't really matter. Again, sets and reps is up to you, how where you want to throw them in your program. I can't really tell you that. Again, reps 5 to 20 is pretty good, works all what you want to work for. Now, as far as optimal training for arms goes, you have to take into account the biceps, triceps and forearms and the different methods that you need to train these optimally. So for the biceps, you need at least the three main things, which is a weighted stretch. Then you need a peak contraction and a heavy loading movement. And personally, I like to include the long head on that, so doing like hammer curls or something. So for example, a peak contraction movement would be like a spider curl. Maybe I'll pull up some footage now of that so you can see it. Then heavy loading would be like an easy bar curl. I'll just pull up footage for all of these. And then a weighted stretch would be like an incline curl. And again, the hammer curls would do for the long head. That's what I think the four things you really need for the biceps. For the triceps, you need to hit the long head, so which is something that you just do overhead, that you can do. The short head you can hit with like a tricep rope push down, which is one rope, or doing like close grip bench press and things like that to hit it a little bit more. Though I don't personally think that compounds are enough to hit what you want to hit for the arms, so you're probably gonna have to isolate it either way for the short and long head of the tricep at least. And you don't really need too much else for the triceps. For the forearms, it's quite complicated. You can use holds for the forearms. You can use curls, obviously. You can do all kinds of curls. You can do the wrist curls, extensions, and all kinds of things. So you kind of have to, forearms are a little bit more complicated, and they can take a lot of punishment. So you can kind of just throw in like whatever you want. And obviously the captain crushers, if you want to get that better grip and just like that strength, grip strength and grip power. And there's just a lot of things you can do for the forearms, but there's no specific optimal way to train the forearms. It depends what you're training your forearms for. But if you just want size, then I would recommend obviously like captain crushers, using those if you have access to them, and just doing like reverse curls, wrist curls, maybe some holds with like a towel holding plates and things like that would be pretty good. Now if you're a bodybuilder, I find that arm training is a must. Obviously you have to take it seriously if you want to look good. Obviously I don't know what your ideal physique is like, but I assume everybody wants big arms pretty much, so you're pretty much gonna have to focus on it. And I would actually say having an arm day makes your life a lot easier if you're training 4 times a week, because when you add that 5 times a week, you can go and do the arms specifically and focus on them. You have a lot more strength and power to do it. A long time I was against doing an arm day because I feel like it was just a waste of time, or I feel like I could not have to do it, but I feel like now that I'm doing it, I actually find it that it's very useful to do, and you should do it, because it's just having that energy and being able to focus on the arms makes a big difference. But it depends what your goals are, and I would go with that. But anyways, in conclusion, for this video, if there's anything else that you would like me to cover, feel free to leave in the comments. I hope you got something out of this video. I just want to explain my arm programming, maybe throw in some arm tidbits, like how to train optimally and things like that, at least in my experience. And I'm definitely looking forward to seeing my own arm progress. I'm definitely going to update it here as well, what I get in terms of progress. I'm probably going to be cutting soon. It's like beginning of March right now. So in April, I'm probably going to start cutting for the summer. So that's going to be interesting as well, to see what I look like. But I'm not going to make much progress probably on the cut, most likely. Either way, thank you for watching the video, and I hope you got something out of it. See you in the next one.